In LumaFusion, you have two different editing modes. You have the default insert mode, as well as an overwrite mode. The insert mode allows you to insert clips between other clips, moving the existing clips out of the way. The overwrite mode will actually overwrite the existing data, meaning that you're going to erase part of a clip that's on the timeline to replace it with what you're dropping in. Let's take a look. I have three clips on the project now, and I'm going to add a fourth one to the end of the timeline here. I'll take this clip here and simply drag and drop it on, and since we're in the insert mode, as you would expect, it just drops it on there, and that's it. If I undo that, and then choose to drop that clip in between these two existing clips, it's going to insert itself between them. As I drag the clip between these two clips, you'll see the bar pop up denoting that it's in the insert mode, and when I let go of the clip, the last clip is moved out of the way, making room for the one that I just dropped in. That's what we're used to seeing so far. But now by opening the track headers, I can switch from insert mode to overwrite mode. When I do that, you'll see two things change. First of all, the arrow here has gone from pointing to the right to pointing down, and the track background has gone from gray to purple. Now that I'm in the overwrite mode, if I go to the end of the timeline and add this clip again, we're not actually going to see any difference than when we're in the insert mode. It just drops it onto the end of the timeline. But if I take that same clip and I drop it between these two clips, first of all, you'll notice that I really can't. There's no indicator showing me that I'm dropping it between the clips. I can replace an existing clip, which is something we'll be exploring in just a moment, or I can drop it anywhere over this edit point, and LumaFusion is going to drop it in place, overwriting the footage that was there. So this shot is now shorter, this shot is now shorter, and this shot has overwritten those clips. Insert versus overwrite has an effect when you're deleting clips as well. I'll go back to the insert mode, and with that new clip still selected, I'll tap the delete button, which will remove the clip and close the gap, moving this shot back into its place. But I'll undo that, switch over to the overwrite mode, select that same clip, and hit delete again, and now we end up with a gap on the timeline. Since when you're in the insert mode, you can't have a gap in the timeline, that gap is filled with a blank clip, which can then be selected and deleted just like any other clip. When you're moving clips around on the timeline, you can also change their behavior by switching between insert and edit mode, just like when you're adding them from the browser. Watch. I'm in the insert mode, and I'll go ahead and drop a clip on the end of the timeline here. And now if I want to move that clip between these two clips here, once I pick it up and move it over, again, we'll see that insert indicator, and if I drop it in place, that last clip has been moved out of the way. I'll undo that and switch over to the overwrite mode. Now when I take this clip and drop it in between these, once again, I can't drop it between them, but if I drop it anywhere else, it simply overwrites the clips that were there, just like when we drag them from the browser. Now let's take a look at what happens when you want to replace a shot on the timeline. Sometimes you have a clip in place that's perfectly timed, it's in just the right spot, but you want to try a different clip in there. So let's take a look at how to do that. Let's say that I want to replace this middle clip with this one here. If I tap and drag this onto the clip, first of all, you'll see the yellow box around the clip indicating that we're about to enter the replace mode. And then when I release the clip, you'll see two different options. Keep the timeline duration or use the new clip duration. The first option, to keep the timeline duration, is going to adjust the out point of the incoming clip so that the overall duration of the clip on the timeline doesn't change. This is really important if you have already edited your project, let's say to music, and you want to make sure that the other clips farther down the timeline don't move. This way, by keeping the duration of the original clip, you will have that same duration of the clip with the new one. However, if you want to replace the clip entirely, meaning that whether the incoming clip is shorter or longer, it simply replaces the whole clip, then you choose the second option. Let's see how they look. I'll start by choosing Keep Timeline Duration, and you can see that the duration of the overall project hasn't changed. I'll undo that, drag that same clip onto there again, and this time choose Use New Clip Duration, and since that clip was shorter, the overall timeline has shrunk. Finally, if you have any effects already applied to your clip, for example, let's say that you had flipped this clip upside down, now when I go to replace the shot, those effects will be maintained. So if I drop a new shot on the timeline, we'll see that that effect, in this case, flipping upside down, has been retained. This is very useful if you've been editing a project and you already have a bunch of effects applied to a clip, for example, filters, color effects, even audio effects that you've applied to a shot, and you're thinking about replacing that shot. When you drag a new shot in to replace the old one, all those old effects are automatically applied, saving you the trouble from having to recreate them.